There are some students who are very good in academics, getting full marks in all the subjects. There are still others who are good in sports. And still others are good speakers or are very good in histrionics. But there are some students who are good in everything. They are all-rounders. Such students, such people are called versatile. You can say they are kind of multitasking people. They can do many things with equal competence. Carbon is like your all-rounder best student. Now why is it so versatile? Let's understand. First thing is that carbon is the only element that can combine with another carbon and thus form very long chains. No other element can do that. Yes, silicon can. Silicon can also combine with hydrogen and form about a chain of 7 to 8 atoms. But this chain is very reactive, unstable. While carbon chains are stable. Isn't it something like our own country? In our country also, we are all bound together. We may be otherwise different, but we are together. Always together. This property of having a strong bond is called catenation. Why I gave the example of your own country, your nation? Because this property has nation in it. Catenation. So the carbon has the property of catenation because of which the compounds are in the form of chains or can be branched or can be in the form of rings. We'll get into the details of these forms. So this is one property of catenation that makes carbon versatile. Secondly, it can form single, double, or triple bond. So whatever the requirement, if one electron is not available, it will make double bond. If two are not available, if one is not available, it will form single bond. If two are needed, double. And if three are needed, triple. So whatever the situation, accordingly it adapts itself. Just like some people, they can make friends with anybody. With lots of people they can make friends. So they are very popular. Even among the students or among the teachers or anybody for that matter, there are some people who can create a bond with any and everyone. So they make friends very easily. Similar is the case of carbon. It can form single, double or triple bond. Another thing is that it cannot, not only forms a bond with carbon, it can also form bonds with others. Once again, just like Indians, not only they have a bond with each other, whichever country they go, they form bonds. So, it can form bond with hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur or halogens. Also, and as a result, you can understand why such a huge variety of compounds. Carbon can combine with carbon can combine with hydrogen, with oxygen, nitrogen, sulfur, halogens like chlorine and bromine. So obviously, the options will be so many. And the result is that not only there is so much of variation, there is variation in the properties also. Again, like India, whosoever came here, we imbibed them, whether they were the invaders or not. As a result, our heritage is so rich. So here also, these outside atoms come and they bring in their own properties, specific properties. Like protein has nitrogen or sulfur, along with of course carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Why? Hydrogen and oxygen along with carbon is present in the fat or the carbohydrates. So like this we find that carbon is a versatile element.